President Trump tonight holding his first official State of the Union, and he was interrupted often.
The state of our union is strong because our people are strong.
And just as he started his speech, the White House announced President Trump has signed an executive order to keep Guantanamo Bay Prison open.
Let's get analysis. Our political reporter Jack Fink joining us tonight with news that the president made throughout this speech.
Well, Doug and Gilma, after a divisive first year in office, President Donald Trump called upon Republicans and Democrats in Congress to set aside their differences and seek common ground. The president also spoke about what he called one American family.
We all share the same home, the same heart, the same destiny, and the same great American flag.
With regard to the flag, the president paid tribute to a 12-year-old boy who helped place American flags at veterans' grave sites. The president said it reminded the nation about how important it is to stand for the national anthem, referring to his battle with the NFL without mentioning the league by name. President Trump also challenged Congress to pass his immigration reforms and reach a compromise on granting a path to citizenship for those brought here illegally by their parents when they were children, in exchange for increased border security and tighter immigration restrictions.
One where nobody gets everything they want, but where our country gets the critical reforms it needs and must have. Set politics aside and finally get the job done.
Also tonight, the president praised his economic policies and the booming U.S. economy. He called for lower prescription drug prices, passing a $1.5 trillion infrastructure bill, and ending the sequestration and fully funding the military. Big issues, and ones that will no doubt spark a lot of debate. Doug?
Jack, thanks very much. One more note about tonight. President Trump and First Lady Melania Trump arrived on Capitol Hill separately. The only reason this has been noted through the night is that traditionally the president and the First Lady will make that ride from the White House over to the Capitol together. But tonight we are told that the First Lady instead opted to ride with the guests that she had invited to sit with her during the State of the Union.
Massachusetts Representative Joseph Kennedy gave the Democratic response, criticizing the president's approach to governing.
They're turning American life into a zero-sum game, where for one to win, another must lose. Where we can guarantee America's safety if we slash our safety net. Where we can extend health care in Mississippi if we gut it in Massachusetts.
Kennedy also addressed Dreamers in Spanish and in English. So what did you think of President Trump's State of the Union speech? Hundreds of you watched and weighed in live during his speech on our CBS DFW Facebook page. You can watch the entire speech there in case you missed it. And we also have a poll still running on Facebook where you can tell us your thoughts.